Now, the inbreeding, we discussed the relationship between the individual. Inbreeding definition, it's mating of individuals whose relationship coefficient is higher than the average coefficient of the relationship for the flock. This is another story, another definition. This is the inbreeding coefficient. Before dealing with inbreeding, we do need to understand, as we previously discussed, the relationship between the individuals, that this relationship, the inbreeding, because we can conclude the inbreeding coefficient from the relationship between individuals. So it is mating of individuals whose relationship coefficient is higher than the average coefficient of relationship for all of the flock. Right? So the inbreeding coefficient that denoted as F right here for right, who produce it at 1921, is defined as the correlation. We can also define it as a correlation between the two gametes to produce the zygotes. What's the correlation between the gamete? And here we are referring to the gametes as the sperms and the ova. What's the correlation between them in terms of genes, not in terms of any other? Because the genes, they produce the traits that we observe phenotypically. F capital here is the inbreeding, is referred to one individual, but coefficient of relationship is between two individuals. Now, you do need to differentiate between the relationship. Usually, the relationship is calculated between two individuals. But if we ask for the inbreeding, it just only the inbreeding is just only for one individual, because it came from the cause of two different individuals. We calculated it from the relationship between individuals. So just only one individual who we can calculate the inbreeding for one individual, but the relationship between individuals, we do need to at least two individuals to solve the problems or to find the relationship between them. And F is estimated as half of coefficient of relationship. Now, the first step, you do need to calculate the coefficient of relationship between individuals. And thereafter, you can see, or you calculate, or estimate the half of the coefficient of relationship to produce the inbreeding coefficient for any certain individual. Example, what's the relationship or coefficient of inbreeding for the individual? Now, the question is totally different from the first one. The first one, we are asking directly the relationship between the first and the second individual. Now, what is the coefficient of relationship between the individual Y? Individual Y, and you can see it from this pathways, as usually we refer from the previous slides, we can rewrite the dendrogram or the pathways in different way. So Y here, we do need to go back to calculate the coefficient of inbreeding relationship, coefficient of relationship between its common ancestors. Okay, so we have A, B, C, and D. Now, the solution. If we go back, first we do need to calculate the relationship between Y and its parents, C and D. They are the direct parents. So, relationship between C and D is about, as we calculated previously in the previous slides, is 0.25 plus 0.25, which we yield 0.5, 50%. The relationship between them is 50%. So the inbreeding, if Y for Y, is the half of this relationship that yielded 0.25. Calculating the coefficient of relationship in case of inbreeding, it is another story that to be discussed later.